I'm hosted.
કેટલે છે
હેલો,
એવું કરતા હશો ને તમે?
Welcome, sir. Shortly, we will be starting the valedictory session, sir.
Okay. Can I join up for 5 minutes?
Sir, maximum 5 minutes, sir. We are waiting for participants to join and a few of our officials to join. That's all, sir. Thank you, sir.
No problem. Let me.
Sir Gopi Singh sir, good afternoon sir.
Gopichand sir, good afternoon.
Yes, sir, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. HOD sir, good afternoon.
From home only or went to college?
Home only, sir.
Okay.
Good afternoon, sir. I have invited our chief guest and I said that maybe in 2 to 2:05 we will be starting and greeted him. So maybe joining by 2:05, sir. Sir, shall we start, sir?
Yes, madam. Yes. Go, you are asking Gopichand, sir. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Actually, sir, joined, madam, a few weeks back only. But
yes, sir. Joined, sir. But we greeted also. We interacted also, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. All are available. They, sir, have unmuted.
Okay. You can sir, greet. Good afternoon, Gopichand, sir.
Sir, good afternoon. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Welcome you all to the validity session of AICT sponsored STTP on Internet of Things IoT based green energy systems. I would like to start with a summary session of this 6 days STTP. We started on Monday with the inaugural address by the chief guest, Dr. S. Selvakumar, IIIT Director, Una, Himachal Pradesh. Subsequently, we have invited the resource person, Mr. Muthu Narayanan, Senior BADW Hyperion Architect, Hexaware Technologies, Chennai, Tamil Nadu. He addressed on the topic IoT in control engineering. Subsequently, the session resource person was Dr. B. Shakila, Assistant Professor, NIT, Nagaland. She addressed on IoT communication and infrastructure. Subsequently, we have invited Ms. Manasi Mishra, Director, ETI Laboratory Private Limited, Delhi. She addressed on IoT communication protocols with hands-on and hands-on practices for Arduino using Tinkercad. And subsequently, Mr. N. Kannan, Chief Architect, Rack Analytics, Bangalore. He addressed on IoT storage options. Subsequently, we have invited Mr. Navaneethan, Vice President, Chief Information Security Officer, Here IT, PayU, Bangalore, Karnataka. He addressed on IoT security challenges and applications. Subsequently, we have invited Dr. Rijo Johnson, Jackson Tom, Assistant Professor, CMR, Institute of Technology, and he is also head of innovation and entrepreneurial cell, Bangalore, Karnataka. He addressed on IoT edge computing in smart cities. Subsequently, we have invited Rajshekaran, Project Assistant at Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, Karnataka. He addressed on IoT robotics arms. And we have invited Dr. Kota Solman Raju, Senior Principal Scientist and Head, CSIR, Central Electronics Engineering Research Institute, Pilani, Rajasthan. Sir addressed on applications of IoT and design issues. Today morning, we have invited Dr. Evelyn Brinda, Professor, Head, at the Karunya Institute of Technology and the Sciences, Coimbatore. She addressed on IoT device energy saving and optimization, green energy. All the resource persons drawn from industry, private institution, and government institution, as well as scientists, a very good combination of resource persons have been invited to this STTP. Everyone, they have contributed to the level, extent, the best, the knowledge sharing and the interaction and clearing their QA session. And they have energized our participant from the beginning to the end. I could see a lot of vibe among participants, lot of chat history I'm having on each and every day. The way participants interacted was awesome. This is what the summarization of the STTP 6 days, what we have organized. Now I am glad to introduce our chief guest, Dr. Gopichand Merugu Garu. He is currently Deputy Secretary in University Grant Commission at Guwahati. Before joining UGC, he was a professor and head of Information Technology Department at Vardhaman College of Engineering, Hyderabad. He received BTech in Information Science and Technology from Nagarjuna University in 2000 and MTech in Software Engineering from JNTU Hyderabad in 2003 and PhD in Computer Science and Engineering from JNTU Anantapur in 2014. He has authored several books. He has published more than 50 papers in peer-reviewed international journals and the conference proceedings. He has guided several masters and undergraduate students for the project and research activities. He is a member of professional bodies like IEEE, ACM, IAENG, CSI, and IST, etc. Welcome you, sir. Now the session is yours. We are keen to hear your insights.
Good afternoon, respected management and principal of the college, and head of the department, Madhubabu sir, and coordinators and coordinator. Good afternoon, and participants especially. Good afternoon to one and all. I hope you had a meaningful sessions and useful sessions, very good sessions for the past 1 week on Internet of Things based on green energy systems. And you had very good speakers, as I see the brochure. I hope you got a lot of useful information and workful information. So for this valedictory, just I would like to brief what kind of research opportunities we can have with respect to not only IoT, about different areas. So coming to IoT, we know this benefits of IoT in renewable in energy is all about automation, cost efficiency, grid management, distributed systems, and residential solutions. So these are some of the benefits, or we can say applications of IoT, where we can make use of the technology, and by using this technology we can resolve many problems and we can provide different solutions for the different problems in various with respect to various aspects. So automation, we can, a smart IoT solution enables to implement automated controls to improve efficiency. And about cost efficiency, IoT in renewable energy solution can substantially cut down our monthly electricity bills. In grid management, IoT not only enables the inclusion of more distributed resources into the grid, but also improves the grid management. And distributed systems, sensors can help in the monitoring of large number of points in distributed systems. And residential solutions, there are a lot of applications that we can make use. The aid of IoT devices, citizens can generate green energy in their backyards to meet their households. These are just benefits, just I would like to point on. So on top, overall, if you can see, any technology, any engineering, any applications, each and everything should be for the sake of people, for society. So whatever the research we do, whatever the technology we use, should be helpful for the society. So there are lots of problems in society where we can resolve that, or we can prepare solutions for those problems by using technology. That is what I strongly believe, and that is the fact actually. So in view of this, Government of India, as you know, it is supporting in lot many ways by funding lots of lakhs of crores of rupees for the sake of doing research. So this includes all different areas. So these are some of the bodies we know. Department of Science and Technology is there, separate ministry, Department of DST. So DST is giving lots of funds to do research for different projects with the in the area of engineering and science technology. So the substitute of DST, Science and Engineering Research Board, SERB. SERB is offering funds, inviting proposals for different projects where particularly IoT, the one is National Mission on Interdisciplinary Cyber Physical Systems. This is the subgroup. So under this group, it is inviting proposals for IoT based projects, if you can see. Particularly, it is you can see in the SERB, Science and Engineering Research Board. Science and Engineering Research Board, and UGC also, University Grants Commission also. Last year, it is launched a STRIDE scheme for transdisciplinary research for India's developing economy. So STRIDE stands for transdisciplinary research for India's developing economy. So STRIDE will support the following in, the innovative research projects like socially relevant, locally need-based, and nationally important, and globally significant. So IoT comes under any of these four research areas. It is socially relevant, whatever we do, locally need-based projects, nationally important, and globally significant also. So there are, you can see, go through the various schemes that are available, and the government is offering, particularly for different sections of the people, like colleges, universities, and different organizations. Government is giving a lot of funding. So I personally, what I can suggest you, all the participants, okay, as you had a session for 1 week, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Audio is perfect, sir.
Yes, sir.
Audio is perfect. Okay. So, as you had a good session for 1 week with different speakers, I hope you got a lot of inputs from various people. You had different people from industry and different combinations, national reputed organizations. So based on the information, you can search the opportunities with different organizations, government organizations. And one government organization that is National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology, that is NIELIT. You can see NIELIT, National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology. It is also having Center of Excellence for IoT and AI. So this Center of Excellence, what way it helps for the people is, it helps to, it promotes the innovation ecosystem in India, comprising of startups, innovators, enterprises, and governments, focusing on solving real world challenges, utilizing technology of like IoT, AI, data science, big data, machine learning, robotics, and through extensive academic research. So so we have to search for different opportunities. So there are many government organizations, ACT, UGC, NI, LIT, and research Center for Electronics and Engineering Research, Pilani. There are Department of Science and Technology, and subunit for DST, that is Science Engineering Research and Board. So there are plenty of direct government institutes are there who are supporting this research funding with respect to various projects, various areas, different areas. So IoT comes with, you can have it with any of the area you can combine with. And there is a lot of scope to get research fundings from government agencies if you have a very good proposal. So my sincere advice, what I can say or what I can suggest to you is, you prepare a good research proposal and try to apply for different agencies, government agencies, and see that you come out with a good product. And you always try to focus on the challenges that are real world challenges. So for example, if you see many of the unknowingly small children there, just by that door lock in car, they are dying. So can't you address such kind of issues? Okay. So what best we can make? Because the unfortunately things are happening in some ways, knowingly, unknowingly. But by using the technology, can it alarms in some way or other way where they can do automatically doors get open or automatically it will be come to some that information or message comes to somebody so that they will go and rescue them. So you try to address the real world challenges. What are the challenges are there? Because technology is not for the sake of increasing the efficiency only or other purposes. But it has to address the ground reality and the real challenges of the humankind. So it should always focus on the safety and security of the either it is a people or data or whatever it is. But serving to mankind is most important thing than any other. So whatever the best things that we can save the lives of people, different and different things that are happening and causing for different kind of incidents or accidents, whatever it is, or unwanted things, you can say. So can you able to stop those by using this technology? Because it is all connecting internetwork of the things, so that it senses it, there will be a lot of sensors where it senses the information and it tries to pass the information to different devices so that they can able to know the information or they can able to control. Okay, so there is a lot of scope. So that is what I can say. You try to always prepare a problems, proposals where that will helpful for to resolve the problems of real world challenges particularly. That is what I feel. And you always look for the proposals. Okay, these proposals will always year-wise throughout the year some proposals may be open and some proposals may be they give notification. So you try to see frequently, you try to visit the websites so that you can know the information, and wherever there is a possibility you try to apply, because these are all the different organizations where they are helping the different sections of the people, that is colleges, universities, national institutes. Lots of crores of rupees they are funding like anything. So it is our responsibility to see that how best we can make use of the funds, and not only making use and just submitting a document of a project. So what exactly the outcome and how it is going to benefit the society, that is very, very important one should think. And if you can see the recent advancements, that is in education system, national education policy, what government has come with revolutionary changes, which is going to have the positive impact and affect the society as well as particularly education sector. So there are lots of changes they have made, whether you have gone through the policy NEP 2020 or not, but you just go through the policy. So there is a lot of scope there. Particularly they have established, they are planning to establish National Research Fund, particularly for research. They have separated one independent body where they can particularly research the fund provides the funds for research. So, and there is a lot of scope that is given in the new education policy for interdisciplinary research, multidisciplinary education, and you can have different, there are lot number of changes, many number of changes they have made where they can help to the students as well as faculty in a, and benefits like anything. What I strongly believe it is going to impact the society, students, faculty and society in a bit positive way. And so there are a lot of opportunities are given in new education policy for funding as well as funding the other schemes as well as for particularly research. So that is what for today's what I would like to brief on the STDP. So because already you had a 1 week sessions, and I hope you all enjoyed and got benefited from the sessions of different sessions from different people. So that is what for these two valedictory address, I thought of giving some useful information regarding brief information about funding opportunities particularly. And some you try to address whenever you submit a proposal, see that it should be a very important one, which can address the real issues of the humankind. So I see the security or safety. Okay, who can save the lives of the people? If any, the technology can help in to save the lives of people. You try to write a proposal where there are many kinds of just simple unnecessary things. People are losing lives with different, knowingly, unknowingly, or with having knowledge, without having knowledge. With different things, how they will work. So each and everything, you try to write a proposals in such a way that it should help to resolve the real issues, particularly which focuses on the security as well as saving the lives of the people. You try to see where there are the opportunities. I have given only one example. That's what small children are when car door is locked small due to not getting oxygen and do not know how to open the door. They are simply losing their life. So there are such kind of similar kind of problems are there in society. So try to address with this kind of technology, and you try to, whenever you get a project, you do with spirit. Okay, means you do it with a good interest, and try to, at the end of the project, you try to produce or try to come with some good outcome, so that can be useful for, or so with some product that can be useful for the society. So with these few words, I would like to thank the management of BVRIT and principal of the PVRIT and head of the department, Dr. Madhubabu sir, and the coordinator of the program, coordinators and participants, and Purnachan for giving me this opportunity. And thank you very much, and all the best.
Thank you, sir. Your words are aptly matched at the end of the session. After the 1 week STTP, we are expecting the participants across the India, as per it is a government sponsored fund. So we need to take it forward in the form of knowledge dissemination with our colleagues, peers, and our students. Next step is conducting vital researches. Subsequently, we may be in the position to execute lot of funded projects suitable to the government progress and the progress of our nation. So it's exactly suitable context you have created, energizing our participants to take it forward, the knowledge which they have gained through this STTP. With that belief only, knowledge acquisition is the primary focus of this AICT sponsored workshop. We believe that you all would have taken part actively in gaining the knowledge rather than just being here. Just a digital count rather than the digital count, I say. So really, the resource person today had given, our chief guest today had given the wonderful insights, what are all the funding agencies or bodies or just kindled. There are so many, inclusive of private agencies also available. The thought process itself is very good, that the next level is with that IoT, we need to take it forward as an academic fraternity. We need to work together. We need to take it forward in the form of knowledge dissemination and research publication, subsequently the funded projects. So thank you so much, sir, for giving the wonderful insight, for making us to work further. Thank you, sir. From the bottom of my heart and on department behalf, I thank you very much. Now I would like to invite our beloved HOD, Dr. Madhubabu Garu, to conclude the session for the 6 days STTP. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, madam. First, before starting, I would like to thank today's chief guest, Gopichand Merugu, Deputy Secretary UGC, and one of my close friend. Thank you, sir. Thanks for accepting, and thank you very much for giving lot of inputs. Are very useful inputs for all of us. And in future also, if any help is there, 100% we will approach you, sir. We will expect the help from you. We are expecting that type of help from you, sir. Thank you very much for your valuable input, sir. Thank you very much. And all other participants, very good afternoon. And CSE department staff and other all staff from BBRIT, very good afternoon to one and all. Thank you very much, all participants, for your sincere participation. And I thank all the resource persons, first of all. Really, I've gone through a few sessions in the last 1 week. So all sessions are really excellent. And the feedback also I have seen. Everything, I'm so happy with the feedback. And especially I need to mention Lakshmi Madam name, Dr. Lakshmi Madam name, the way she handled when because of power failures, Gopi Chansar, because of power failures, in one or two cases, from resource person side, some network problem was there. Immediately, Madam started another topic and she covered for a few minutes. Like that, she handled things very nicely. Thank you very much, Lakshmi Madam.
Thank you, sir.
Really, really great things to see, Madam, actually. I'm so happy the way you handled the things, sir. And from my heart, I thank Dr. Pichi, sir. Really did a wonderful job. From the last 3-4 months, the efforts to get the information from the resource persons to, while interacting with resource persons, how much time you have spent, I've seen. What topics they are going to cover, everything. How to schedule all these things, the order, everything. He did a lot of homework and everything went on very well. And I congratulate Dr. Pichi, sir, and I thank him for his efforts. And all the, and Dr. Purnachand to coordinate the things really smoothly, everything. And all other members of the CSE department also who contributed in this STTP. I thank each and every member. Once again, I thank all the participants for your sincere participation, and all the best to everyone. Thank you once again.
Thank you, sir, for your concluding session. Now I request our participants, I have given the permission to unmute yourself. You can come out with your feedback and the gaining of experiences.
Yes,
this is the moment we can. This is the moment our department can cherish the success stories of the workshop. We are expecting any few of you would like to come forward and give your feedback and your whatever the feel or experience you have gained out of this STTP.
Can I leave, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Participants, we are inviting you to come forward to give a word of thanks, a few words about the workshop, whatever the knowledge you have gained or experiences you have gone through. Our HOD and the entire team is available. That's why I'm requesting you. Earlier you have interacted, but however, during the concluding session, it would be much more beneficial. Yes, ma'am. Please proceed. Yeah.
Good afternoon to all.
Hello, ma'am. Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Two members.
Actually, actually, myself, Gajendran from Karpam College of Engineering, Coimbatore. I am sorry to say that I am not registered for this STTP.
That's fine, sir. You have participated.
I got the link from my colleague. We are taking the same subject, that's why we shared the link, and last 1.5 days only I am able to attend that workshop. It's a very nice session, ma'am. Especially today morning I attended that Green IoT. These are very, very useful for us. And also in yesterday's session also that robotic, how to design robotic arm. All the presenters are made their effort very well. And they were given all the practical inputs to us. Definitely, we will follow all the things in our future works. We will guide the students
we will do our research work and we will give it to our society also. Thanks a lot for the organizers and everyone. And also I thank the AICT for giving this wonderful opportunity. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you for your kind words, sir. Thank you. Anyone would like to come forward? Yes, good
Hello.
Evening.
Yes. Yes, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am. Ma'am, this is Gajendra Singh Mori from Mandvi Education Society, Surat, Gujarat.
One of the active participants, I welcome you. You are
ma'am, you are so cooperative, ma'am. Yes. And ma'am, thanks to arrange and manage these types of STTP. I really found lots of things because I'm doing work on IoT. Actually, my research going in IoT. So that's why I joined in this session, this STTP. So I got lots of things from this. So thank you very much to all who arrange and manage this thing. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Sinha, madam, are you there? Thank you, sir. Another active participant, Sinha. Nidhi Sinha, are you there? Every session she was there, now not available.
She raised the hand also, madam, few minutes back.
Yeah, sir, I had given unmute operation options to everyone, sir. Anyone can unmute and they can come forward, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, anyone else would like to share your feedback or your experiences or your whatever you gained out of
this? One small request, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
If you are conducting a further FDPs, please update us in any one forum, ma'am.
Definitely, sir. Group or this group will go ahead, sir. It will not be dissolved, sir. We will update all our correspondences, sir.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Anyone? There is a kid, I think, non-IoT participant. Any other IoT Hello? Participants? Yeah. Welcome,
evening,
sir.
Madam.
Yeah. Good evening, sir.
But this is Dr. Sayada, sir.
Yes, sir. One of the active participants and yeah, always you
I
will
think
be.
You remember. I requested for a practical.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. 100% attendance you maintained.
Yes, madam. Yes, sir. Thank you very much for the request fulfilled by you people, madam.
Yes, sir.
Because I requested for IoT hands-on and you gave from robotic, how you can plan for. And how the practical work, what you did, the sir said, everything he has shown. So actually, because of my busy schedule, I missed some of the modules, means some of the timing because of the network issues.
Yes, sir. That's right.
Yeah,
sir.
But I hope everything is well planned and well organized. So from my inner heart, I'm making you more thanks. I'm for all management as well as the whoever they're behind. So I thank everyone from mine because it is such a type of FDP or what I felt. It is hands-on, it is more informative, and it helps us in planning further in IoT.
Fine, sir. Thank you, sir, for your insights.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Anyone you feel that you are missing to interact at the end of the concluding session, if you wish to communicate, you can communicate.
Good afternoon. I'm Padmaja from Tegal Krishna Reddy Engineering
College. Good afternoon, ma'am. Welcome, ma'am.
I missed one or two sessions, madam. Only in the afternoon session and one morning session. But it was very wonderful session. And I don't know where you get the energy. Each and every participant... You observed very keenly, and the way you organized the workshop is wonderful, and the way you handled when something went wrong, as some sir told, that you handle in a very good manner, and I hope we'll get further information if any FDPs from BVRIT, ma'am.
Definitely, ma'am.
And, thank you from bottom of my heart. I learned something. And in future also, we'll extend this and we'll show what we learned to the students.
Thank you. That is the blessings of this STTP. Very good, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you.
Madam, I want to... I forgot one.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Without you, I don't think this FDP might not have that successful.
It's not like that. So we are working as a team. We really, I say...
I agree with you.
Yeah. So everyone agrees to the point, madam, because you led the team like anything.
Yes, sir. But one thing I can say, our HOD is a very motivating and kind person. He will give much extent the freedom. That is what makes me to work energetically. That is also a highlight. And I have a very good team in the department to execute. That is another highlight of our department. That's also. Thank you, sir.
Wonderful, madam. Wonderful, wonderful. Lakshmi, madam.
Every member participated and you gave every role to the people.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. But anyway, we are very thankful that you have led the team. Thank you. Thank you. Yes,
sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes,
anybody is giving feedback or just unmuted and
Yeah, good afternoon, ma'am. This is
Good afternoon, sir.
This is Avinash from CVR College of Engineering.
Yeah, one of the active participants again, Avinash, sir.
Yeah, actually, I have attended the previous workshop also. From there, I got the link to opportunity.
Sound okay, attend this. And
yeah. Aneda Chandra, please mute your. Yeah.
Yeah, the workshop was organized very well. I see that it's AACT sponsored 1 week online HTTP. And as the pandemic, this corona is having effect, we are doing the workshops in the, I know how hectic will be to conduct this kind of workshops in the online. Even we face many problems with the teaching in the online. So, but you have organized very well. The entire team have organized very well and the management have given very good opportunity to give such kind of workshops, that too internet. Things based on green energy systems, which is emerging technology in the right now. So all the speakers are very eminent in their field and we have achieved some knowledge in that, how the sensors will be working and how the Arduino and these things will be working. So I got some knowledge on that. I think I will be benefited with this and also these the participants will be getting benefited by these workshops. And thanks for giving every time. If we are going to miss some classes you are going to post the video links, that will be very helpful in future. Thank you very much, madam, for organizing such kind of workshop.
Thank you very much, sir, for detailed feedback which you had given. Actually, we promised that we'll be giving you material. We are collecting from each and every resource person. Everybody is drawn from busy schedule. Few of them are not responding. That is the reason we are delaying. By evening, we will be sharing all the PPTs and recorded video already shared, and today's recording, including this validity session, whatever the funding proposal our chief guest mentioned, you can watch through the video and you can get to know if you missed a few of you the terminologies. Nothing to worry. So feedback link and the quiz link is already has been shared and it will be kept open till 5 o'clock. No need to hurry up, no need to be tensed. The link will be shared in the chat window at the end of the concluding session as well as in the WhatsApp group as well. And now I invite Dr. Pichai, who is the backbone or the star of this STTP, who got the fund from AACT proposal. I request Dr. Pichai, sir, to give you a vote of thanks.
Thank you, madam. Good evening to everyone. Dr. Gopichand, sir, then our beloved HOD, sir, and dear participants. Great. Thank you, everyone. We appreciate you being here. It is my privilege to propose a vote of thanks. I must mention our deep sense of appreciation to all our resource persons from day one to day six. We are privileged to have interaction with Dr. Gopichand. He is currently Deputy Secretary in University Grand Commission at Guwahati. Thank you, sir. Yeah, big thanks to our visionary chairman, Sri K.V. Vishnu Raju Garu, Dynamic Vice Chairman, Sri Ravichandran Rajagopal Garu, respected Principal Dr. Lakshmi Prasad Sir, from their constant support for the successful conduction of this AACT-sponsored STTP. Very important, I thank to our beloved HOD, Dr. C.H. Madhubabu, who encouraged us to do our best, and always he motivates with us his positive words. Thank you, sir. With the deep sense of appreciation, we thank our STTP moderator, Dr. Lakshmi Madam. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir.
I thank the organizing team, Dr. Poonachan, sir, Mr. Abdul Subhan and Mr. Mara Verman. I acknowledge the contribution of those who worked behind the screen for the successful conduction of this STTP. Really, I thank from our bottom of our heart to one and all. Last but not least, I thank all the participants for their great enthusiasm and learning inclination. Thank you, one and all. I wish you all success. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir. Concluding session has come, lot of appreciation have come in the chat window. I thank each and every one of you for expressing your feedback and thankfulness and your experiences in the text as well. I need to acknowledge you also. There are many audio notes. However, I need to acknowledge the textual expression as well. With that both of the group will be available from the beginning. After the lockdown, almost we have arranged a one day webinar, half day webinar, and 1 week FTP. So many events we have arranged on behalf of computer science and engineering, and the same group is retained till date. Similarly, your WhatsApp group is also retained. We will be posting all the useful information or links or our activities, whatever we are arranging, the FDPs or short term course or webinar or workshops. We request you to come forward and take participation in our sessions. Thank you, one and all. Thank you, sir. HOD sir, if you wish to communicate anything with the participants, you can communicate, sir. Thank you, one and all. The link I have shared in the chat window, both link, feedback link and the MCQ link, both link will be kept open till 5 o'clock. After ending the session, it will be shared in the WhatsApp group as well. Nothing to worry if you have not noted down. Otherwise, I'll be sharing once again. The link right now, which I'm going to share, is for quiz. Now the link which I'm sharing, this is for quiz. Several times I have shared. If you would have not noted down, you can note it down right now. This is the link for feedback. Now I am going to share. This is the link for feedback. So both of the links have been shared. So these two links are important to take part for the certification. 50% pass mark only have been set. 50 or 60 ACT have given the permission to issue the certificate after the assessment. So we have set 50%. So if we are 50% pass mark or whatever the score is expected for the issue of certificate. With that, wish you all success. Thank you, one and all. I thank HOD and the coordinator and the entire Department of Computer Science and Engineering, BVRIT, and our principal and every one of you, and the participants as well. Thank you, one and all. Let us conclude the session, and I'm going to end the meeting. We can leave.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Madam, thank you so much, madam.
Thank
Wonderful.
You, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, Amjan, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Your efforts only, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, madam. Sir. Thank you all.
Thank you to all.
Vijay, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Thank you all.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Yes, thank sir. Pichai sir left that place. He's now in my cabin. So I'll convey the thanks, sir.
Welcome, madam.
Yeah, heavy rain is coming, madam. Actually, neither.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Correct, sir. Heavy rain.
Yes, well, heavy rain, sir. College also heavy rain, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you once again, all participants. Thank you very much, and all the best.
Yes, sir. Thank you all. Wish you all success. Thank you all.